32, we're also using properties of logarithms. Again, here's two questions on very similar things, so make sure you know that on the test there's going to be something about properties of logarithms. So notice we've got the same bases here. Now this one, there's actually two properties, so we're going to evaluate each of the expressions. I actually use the properties of logarithms to evaluate each of the following expressions, so we end up with actually just a number. So first of all, what we'll do is go ahead and use our properties. So kind of using order of operations, we will rewrite this with this 2 becoming an exponent on the 3. So this becomes log base 5 of 45 minus log base 5 of 9. 3 squared. Then that gives us division, 45 divided by 9, because we've got this negative, we're subtracting, log base 5, 45 divided by 9. 45 divided by 9 is 5, so there's the log of 5, log base 5 of 5. And whenever the base is the same, the base down here is the same as the input, the exponent is the answer. So this is 5 to the first power, so the answer of this is 1. So all of that to get up to the answer for the first one, just the number 1. Okay, so let's do the second one. We're adding, so we're going to be able to actually multiply these two, so we get natural log of e to the minus 9 times e to the 5. When you're multiplying, so that's all inside the natural log. Natural log of e to the, so we add exponents when you multiply like this, so this will be e to the minus 4 power. And natural ln is you could write it this way, it's the log base e. So again, we use the same property when the base of the exponent and the input are the same. The answer is the exponent. Minus 4 is our answer. But that's a tricky one. You just have ln is natural log. That's log base e. It's just a different way of writing it. But anyway, our answer is the exponent, and that's 32 using properties of exponents.